It's a very simple solution how to get this game competitive. Like the MLB used to do. Team who wins gets home field advantage. Get rid of the draft. I understand the draft was exciting when they first came out with it because it was something different. Go back to the Western Conference versus the Eastern Conference. Whoever wins this game gets home court advantage in the NBA Finals. Watch how hard they play. Watch how much that means to them. Because these players, these superstars, their legacies are on the line. And they get an advantage, whether they aren't necessarily in position to have a better seed than a team in another conference, then that game will be competitive. Trust me, it will be competitive. That is a simple solution. I would love that idea. Because as fans, we deserve to see the best players in the world go head to head and in a competitive game. Sure, the half court shots are cool and all that. The alley-oops and the dunks are cool. I get it. But you want that game competitive? Western Conference versus Eastern Conference. Whoever wins gets home court advantage in the NBA Finals. Trust
That
me,
would
it will be competitive.
such a stupid rule in the MLB though, because that would like I don't know, man. Like you're totally right. That would make them play hard, but like you don't think LeBron would be sobbing to Adam Silver if they did that? Like the players would not go for it first of all, because let's be honest, it's a player-run league now. And second of all, when they did in the MLB, people were so mad about it. They thought it was so stupid. They thought the All-Star game should really have no reason, and then no reason to impact, you know, the World Series, like the biggest game in sports. Just because guys who are like excuse me, in the NBA, like somebody on the Minnesota Timberwolves, like Cat's gonna play his ass off because the Lakers might get home field advantage. Like, no, I don't know. Like, they're not gonna do that in the NBA, and even if they did, it would just be stupid. That said, it would make them play hard, and if that's what the route you want to go to, then fine. But in the MLB, they still play hard. Like, well, how come they still do that? Like, they still play hard. It's more fun. It's loose, but they still like you still see like pitchers throwing 99, like it's baseball. You know, maybe that's just because baseball is a different sport, but I don't know.
Football is a sport that you're never going to be able to really figure that one out in terms, because it's just how violent the sport is and how injuries come across it. There's really no way that the NFL could fix the Pro Bowl. The Pro Bowl, it is what it is. Baseball is different, and I love that rule. It just adds more spice to the game because you only get so many at bats. Like, you're going to still take your at bat seriously. It's not going to make or break you in terms of your season or risk injury or tire you out more. It's an at bat. And as a pitcher, if I throw 99 on Tuesday, I'm going to throw 99 on Saturday. I mean, that part doesn't matter about it. But the NBA, defense is all about effort. The only way to get defense involved is have them play for something. The charity money, that's great, and they should keep that. It's not enough. If they have the home court advantage, the stars will show out, and the best players who are in title contention, which again, you could look at the Eastern Conference, assuming all health. You could have a starting lineup of the Nets big three, Giannis, and Embiid. All three of those have a chance to be in the NBA Finals this year. So right then and there, you have five guys who are going all out. And then you have the Western Conference. If AD was healthy, you have LeBron, AD, you have Kawhi, and then that's already three guys in your starting lineup who have title aspirations to get that home court advantage. It's just extra spice for the fans, and it doesn't necessarily mean that. Because a team in the Eastern Conference has a better record than the Western Conference, they were better when they're playing entirely different teams all year long. So this would be a perfect opportunity to make the game competitive, go Western Conference for Eastern Conference, and we could see the best players in the world going head to head and going at it. That's what I love about it.
What if one of them goes out and breaks their leg in the All-Star game?
I mean, that's life. I mean, it's unfortunate. My condolences will go out to them. Like,
The
I feel bad.
All-Star game?
I wish them a speedy recovery, but that's just a part of basketball. That's a part of the sport. Just as a part of sports. You can get hurt any game. Just because they're playing lax defense doesn't mean you can't get injured. All it takes is one little step to pop your Achilles or your ACL or something amongst those lines. That can happen in practice. That can happen in a game. Just because it's an all-star game, they're still choosing to play.
How would that look if that's an all-star game and a guy goes down and tears your Achilles? Listen, no one's getting hurt right now just jogging down the court chucking up threes. But if you're getting barreled down, like if Joel Embiid's in the paint going up against, you know, say somebody with the likes of Steph Curry, and he swats him and he jumps down on his ankle and now we got an injury in the all-star game. Hypothetical, but this stuff happens. Like we saw Carlton Fisk in the MLB All-Star game when this rule was implemented. Pete Rose took him out at home plate. His career was never the same.